Hello and welcome to the Scriptcase update video. Scriptcase with PHP 8.1 is around the corner. And to prepare you, we will today be looking into some of the important aspects that you will need to keep in mind for migration from your previous projects to PHP 8.1 or with a new installation. My name is Jamie Oates and I am your host today. With this new release of Scriptcase and the upgrade of PHP to 8.1, you will see a major improvement on performance. As you can see from this chart, we have double-digit improvements versus previous versions of PHP. Using php.net as our source, we have statistics showing this performance increase over previous PHP versions. So your applications will generate faster, they will also work faster. And if you look at the important life cycle of PHP, we will see that the support provided for 8.1 is also much longer, and most importantly, the security support, meaning that 8.1 will receive updates all the way into 2024, where 8.0 will finish in 2023 for all of those very important security updates. As the current version of PHP 7.4 used for Scriptcase is no longer supported, we will be moving to this most recent release with major security updates, which is now maybe 4 months old. With improvements to the PHP language, speed improvements, as well as other advantages and new features. There are also new classes, functions, as well as the usual depreciations which we will need to be aware of, all of which you can study further on the PHP 8.1 webpage. With this update, Scriptcase will run faster, be more reliable, and have the latest security updates applied, keeping you up to date with today's standards. The most important aspects regarding changes in your code, if you have coded by hand or use the security apps that are generated within Scriptcase for your project, then this will affect you. We will be covering those points in a few moments so that you are fully prepared for the transition to this better and faster version of Scriptcase. Okay, so with the new version of PHP, there are some important changes, additions, and depreciations which you will need to be aware of. We have classes and new features which are very interesting. There are also some discontinued variables and functions. Okay, so before we begin, it is important that you back up your Scriptcase. I would also back up or export your projects so that you have them separately available as an extra precaution. Then you can download the new version once available within the next few days, install it as a new installation, and it is important to note here that you do not need to uninstall the old version of Scriptcase. You can install it side by side. Then you can upload your backup, recover from it within Scriptcase, or import each project if that is how you want to go, and then you will be ready to continue. So I am already logged into Scriptcase here, and I have here a blank application as well as a security folder, so a group security has already been created here. And I'm going to quickly go over the various configurations or settings that you will require for the latest version of PHP. So we have here the first example, which is then for the curly and hard brackets. And we have here, first of all, our array as we would provide that with PHP 7 or previously. So we construct our array, and we have an ABC. We have then the indicator of where we want to grab within our array, which is here the number 1. And then here we echo that. And here you notice that we are using curly brackets. And in reality, this entire line is no longer needed. And curly brackets is actually no longer supported. So if I go ahead and run that now, it should actually present me with an error message, which for some reason it's not doing right now. It should actually present you with fatal error that curly braces are no longer supported. I don't know why it's not actually doing that right now, but it shouldn't. You notice it's also not outputting anything, okay? So if we actually return back into Scriptcase and adjust that here, so we use here the PHP 8 code. And if I change that here and now run that, we are actually outputting the data from our array. instead of actually an error message or blank as we had just now, and as I mentioned, it should actually be presenting an error message. I don't know why it's not right now, but previously it has done. Okay, so our next function is also another important one, and again, I can demonstrate that. So here we have variables containing null. So within PHP 7, if I run that here, we have the price 2, quantity is nothing, and then we have a total equals the price times the quantity, and then we're echoing the total price. So if I go ahead and run that now, and we can see then that we have then here an error message, and it's a fatal error, uncaught type error, unsupported operand types init string in C, and then it's going to continue on with the data here. Now we can actually see here that we have a null variable or null or nothing basically provided here for the quantity. So that is important that if I edit that here now, we can see then here below for PHP 8, we have pretty much the same thing again. We have the price equals 2, the quantity this time equals 0, okay? And then the total equals the price times the quantity, just as we had previously. And again, we are going to echo the total. And if I go ahead and run that, we now receive our output as total 0, as it should be. So the next important one for within your own code, so let me edit this here again, if I change that here and comment that out, and then we have the for each function which no longer exists. So that is very important. So here we have a result which is nothing, and we have a tab which is then an array of objects. So we have here basically a table, you could say, as 1 VL AA BB CC, so 1 2 3 AA BB CC, and the PHP 7, for instance, we would create a bar with each as a tab, and then we were going to print the bar. So now if I go ahead and remove here first of all the PHP 8 and run that, you can see once again that we have a fatal error. Okay, undefined function each, meaning each no longer exists within PHP 7. So that is very important to note. So if I go ahead and comment here the PHP code out again, and we can use here the for each and loop it basically, and then echo the results within each key, and then run that, we will now see the correct data being displayed here, and there we have here our result. So we have AA, AA, BB, AA, BB, CC, just as we have coded here within our little piece of code. So just to quickly review those again, if you have coded anything within Scriptcase within the new version or within previous versions or any version of Scriptcase at all, you import that into the new version of Scriptcase once you have installed it, then you will need to make adjustments to anything or any applications where you have used these specific functions and features of PHP 7.4 or previous versions of PHP which are no longer supported. If you have generated your entire project with Scriptcase with no hand coding whatsoever, then you will not need to make any changes here. So we have here, first of all, curly brackets are no longer supported for arrays. We need to use the hard brackets at all times. Variables containing null is no longer supported, so we can no longer add a null value or nothing into a value. So for instance here for the quantity, we would need to add a value here being 0. So the next function is each, which is no longer available, so that has been deprecated and removed from PHP 8.1. So that is very important to note, so do keep those in mind, and then of course make those adjustments and changes within your own code once you have imported your projects into the new version of Scriptcase. Okay, so before we go, I have one more thing to show you, and that is for security. So this is very important. If you have generated security for your platform within Scriptcase previous to the 8.1 version or the PHP 8.1 version, which will soon be released, then you will also need to make these adjustments. So within the security application, app login, we can then access here programming and PHP methods. And within PHP methods, so here we have the remember underscore me underscore validate method, and here we would need to make some changes. And here you can already see I have this commented out here from PHP 7. We would have here our code equals the character with a random number, 0 and max. Now notice that this is actually using curly braces here for an array, as we have this, the characters here, combined as an array. And what we have then is the curly braces here, and we would need to adjust that to as we have here below with the hard brackets. Okay, so this is very important that that is then changed within the remember me validate method within the app login security page, which has then been generated within previous versions of Scriptcase. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you've enjoyed, and until next time.